In last class, we studied that evaporation and what is the effect of evaporation and some examples. Then the last concept of this chapter, that is factor affecting the evaporation. Before this, what do you mean by evaporation? The evaporation is nothing but the conversion of water liquid into the vapor below its boiling point. The conversion of liquid into vapor, we can call it as a evaporation. Then when evaporation causes the cooling effect. Okay, we already know that. Then what are the factors which affect the evaporation? Means when the evaporation is more and when the evaporation is less, and how and what are the factors which affect the evaporation? Means what are the factors which increase the rate of evaporation, means conversion of liquid to vapor, or which factor which decrease the rate of evaporation, we will study in this topic. Then factor affecting the evaporation, there are different factors which affect the evaporation. In that the first concept, that is humidity in air. Okay, the first factor, that is humidity in air. The amount of humidity in air also affect the evaporation. Then what it means, humidity? What do you mean by humidity? The humidity is nothing but the amount of air present, the amount of water vapors present in the air, means the amount of water vapors present in the air. The amount of water vapors present in the air, we can call it as a humidity. Is called humidity. Means what is the amount of water present in the air, we can denote it as a humidity. Okay, then consider when the humidity is more, means when the amount of water vapor in air is more, then the humidity is more. When the amount of water vapor in air is less, then humidity is less. Then how the humidity affect the evaporation? Means when the amount of water vapor present in the air is more, is evaporation is more or less? When the amount of water vapor in air is less, then the evaporation is more or less. Now we will study. Okay, before that, now consider one thing, that is when humidity in air is low. When humidity in air is low means the amount of water vapors are low. Okay, it means water vapors are less. The humidity in air is low means the amount of water vapors are less. Then we can call it as a dry air. When the humidity is less or low, means when the water vapors are less, then we can call it as a dry air. Okay, like that. When the humidity in air is high, okay, then we can call it as a wet air. Means it is nothing but water vapors are more. When the humidity is less means the water vapors are less. Okay, when humidity in air is low, we can call it as a dry air. When the humidity in air is high, then we can call it as a wet air. Now, what happens when the humidity in air is low? Means that is dry air. When the humidity in air is high, that is wet air. What happens when in such condition? Now, we will study. Let's now consider two conditions. One is high humidity. High humidity means this one. High humidity, the amount of air, humidity in air is high, means wet air. When the humidity is high, then it implies the evaporation less. Means when the humidity is high, the evaporation is less. Means when the humidity is high, means wet air. Just consider this air, the rainy season. In rainy season, is humidity is high or low? Yes, in rainy season, the air is wet. But what about in summer season? The humidity is low, means the air is dry. Because of that, when the humidity is high, when the amount of water in air is high, then the evaporation is less. Because of that, in a rainy season, cloths take a long time to dry. Yes or no? Because the humidity is high. Because the amount of air, amount of water vapor in air is high. Because of that, in a rainy season, the cloths take long time to become dry. But what happens when the humidity is less? Okay, high humidity. Low humidity. When the humidity is low, then the evaporation is high. Why the evaporation is high when the humidity is low? Because when the humidity is low, it is dry air. Means when the humidity is low, the water vapors are less. In the summer season, the air is dry or the air is wet? In the summer season, the air is dry. Okay, means the water vapors are very, very less. But in the rainy season, the air is wet. Means the water vapors are more. Because of that, in high humidity, evaporation is less. Because of that, it takes a long time to dry the cloths. Okay. But in low humidity means when the evaporation is high. If humidity is low, the evaporation is high. Because of that, it takes a very short time to dry the cloths. Because of that, in summer season, the cloths dry very quickly. But in rainy season, in winter season, it takes a long time to dry the cloths. This is the first factor which affects the rate of evaporation, that is humidity. So then, the next factor which affect the evaporation is nothing but temperature. Okay, just imagine, when the temperature is more, is the evaporation is more or less? When the temperature is less, is the evaporation is more or less? Just imagine, in summer, what happens? The cloth, any surface becomes dry very quickly. But what about in rainy season or winter season? Any surface, if the surface is wet, then that wet surface takes a long time to become a dry. Because in a summer, the temperature is more. Because of that, the conversion of liquid into vapor, it becomes very quickly. But in a summer or rainy season, the temperature is very, very low. Because of that, the conversion of liquid into vapor, it takes some time. Because of that, the next one factor, that is temperature. Okay, now consider, if temperature is more, what happens? When the temperature is more, the evaporation is also more. When the temperature is less, when the temperature is less. When the temperature is less, the evaporation is less. Okay, means when the temperature is more, the evaporation is more. When the temperature is less, the evaporation also less. Because when the temperature increases, what happens? It increases the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy also increases. When the temperature increases, the kinetic energy also increases. When the kinetic energy increases, what happens? The movement of particle is more. Because of that, the interparticle space increases suddenly and the force of attraction decreases suddenly. Because of that, when the temperature is more, kinetic energy increases. When the kinetic energy increases, the conversion of liquid into vapor, it becomes very quick. But when the temperature is less, means decreases, the kinetic energy is also decreases. Because of that, because when the kinetic energy decreases, what happens? The movement of particle, the motion of particle is very, very less. Because of that, the conversion of liquid into vapor is low. The conversion of liquid into vapor in this case high. When the temperature decreases, the kinetic energy also decreases. Because of that, the evaporation is less. But when the temperature is more, the evaporation is also more. Okay, when you start heating, the liquid is converted into gaseous state very quickly. But when the temperature is less, it takes some more time to convert that liquid into gas. Just think, when you heat the liquid, what happens? When you heat the liquid under high flame, the boiling of that or the conversion into liquid into vapor, it becomes very quick. But when you decrease the heat, what happens? The liquid, it takes more time to convert into vapor. Because of that, this is the next factor, that is temperature. Then the next factor, that is surface area of the liquid. Surface area of the liquid. Yes, then the next factor, that is surface area of liquid. What happens when, how the surface area affect? Just imagine you have some surface area. Surface area means usually this evaporation is a surface phenomena. Okay, now consider two thing. One is a surface area is more. Surface area more and surface area less. Surface area less. Okay, so what happens when surface area is more? What happens when surface area is less? We will discuss. Okay, before that, just consider two things. Just imagine you have one test tube. Okay, and you have another one, that is the large surface area beaker. Or just take this one is glass and this one is water, any large container. Yes, add some water. Okay, add water in both. Okay, add water in both. Between these two, which is more in surface area? Yes, of course, the red one is more in surface area. And what about this pink one? That is less in the surface area. Sorry, this is less in surface area. Red one, this is more in surface area. Just now imagine, between these two, in which the evaporation is more quick, or in which the evaporation is less? In the pink beaker, sorry, in this beaker or in this container, the evaporation is more, because the more particles are exposed to air. But what about this? The less particles are exposed to air. Because of that, when you place these two outside to the sun or air, the evaporation is more quicker in this one, but the evaporation is less in this one. Because of that, if the surface area is more, If the surface area is more, then evaporation is more. When the surface area is less, then evaporation is also less. Then when surface area is more, the evaporation is also more. When the surface area is less, the evaporation is also less. Because why? Because this evaporation is surface phenomena. When you consider the less surface area, the amount of particles exposed outside or exposed to air is less. But when you consider the more surface area, the amount of particles, the number of particles exposed to air or outside is more. Because of that, when the more number of particle is exposed, then those all particles convert into vapor. But when the less number of particles exposed to air, the only less number of particles are converted into vapor. Because of that, the evaporation is more in the more surface area, the evaporation is less in less surface area. Okay, now consider some examples. Just imagine when you spread the wet cloth. Okay, when you spread wet cloth. So when you spread the wet cloth, drying of these cloths means, just imagine you are drying, you want to dry the cloths, okay? You spread the cloths or you just fold the cloths, okay? Means after washing the cloths, okay? After washing the cloths, your cloths spread, okay, spread over the air, not you fold like this, yes or no? When you spread the cloths or when you spread the sari to air, means when you spread the wet cloths to dry them in air, what happens? The evaporation is increases because the surface area is more. But when you fold and keep the cloths, what happens? The evaporation is more or less? The evaporation is less because you are folding the cloths, you not increase the surface area. Because of that, when you spread the wet cloths to dry them in air, there is an increase in surface area. Because of that, the evaporation of water the evaporation of water is more. Because of that, the cloths get dry faster, okay, but not in this case, okay, because you are not spreading the surface area is less, but in this case the surface area is more. Then the next one, when you are in hurry, okay, means you want to go to office, but already time is more, okay, but you want to drink a tea, okay, during that time what you do, okay, you pour your hot water to one plate, yes or no? Initially you are drinking, your tea in the cup, okay, but when you saw the time, it's already 10 o'clock, but you are hurry, you want to go to office very quickly. During that time you transfer this tea or any milk to this plate. Then what happens when you transfer this? It reduces the temperature because initially in the cup, the surface area of this is less. But when you transfer it to plate, the surface area is more. Hence, it increases the rate of evaporation. Hence, the temperature of the tea becomes low. Then, we will easily drink it. And as this is the another one. Means, just this you know this sauce, okay, saucer. Okay, tea and saucer, you transfer tea into saucer or tea into plate because to increase the rate of evaporation, to decrease the temperature of your tea. This is the another one example. And just imagine after the rain, your roads, the wet roads becomes dry very quickly. Yes or no? After the rain, your wet roads becomes dry very quickly because the surface area of your roads are more. The surface area of your road. Surface area of road is more. Because of that, it becomes dry very quickly. Because of that, when the surface area is more, the evaporation is more. When the surface area is less, the evaporation is less. This is a one more factor. Then the next one, consider speed of wind. Then the speed of wind. Speed of wind. Then speed of wind is how the speed of wind affect the evaporation. Yes, when the speed of air increases, speed of wind is increases, what happens? The is now consider two factor. One is speed of wind is more, and speed of wind is less. Okay, these are two cases. When the speed of wind is more, just imagine you are you want to dry the clothes. Okay, yes, how you dry? You increase the air, yes or no? When the air is more, the clothes becomes dry very quickly, but when air is less, the clothes becomes it takes a long time to dry. Because of that, to dry anything or to convert liquid into vapor, you should increase the wind. Just imagine you are in the hurry. Okay, you want to go to office, but you want to drink the tea. During that time, you increase the air by blowing. Yes or no? You blow your tea, and the blowing of tea is nothing but you increase the speed of wind. When the speed of wind is increases, what happens? The hot tea becomes cool. Because of that, when the speed of wind is more, the evaporation is more. When the speed of wind is less, the evaporation is also less. Because of that, this is one more factor, speed of wind. When the speed of wind is more, the evaporation is more. When the speed of wind is less, the evaporation is less. This is one more. Means, yes, when the clothes dry fast on windy day, yes or no? When the wind is more, the clothes becomes dry very quickly. But when the wind is less, the clothes not becomes, means it takes a long time to dry the cloth. This is a one more, that is speed of wind. Then the last factor, that is nature of liquid. Yes, there are two type of liquid. Just imagine, yes, nowadays you are using the sanitizer. Okay, yes, just take a two drop of water in one hand, and just take a two drop of water in one hand and two drop of sanitizer in another hand. Okay, which convert, means which becomes dry very quickly, either water or sanitizer, or which convert that liquid into vapor, either water or sanitizer? Yes, of course sanitizer, because of nature of the liquid. And just take a petrol. Okay, when you pour petrol on any surface, what happens? It dry very quickly, or it convert liquid into vapor very quickly. But when you pour water on the surface, it takes some time because of the nature of liquid. In another words, we call them as a volatile or non-volatile. Yes, what you mean volatile or non-volatile, you will study in the upcoming classes. But what happens? Just take your alcohol and water, or petrol and water. Okay, between these two, the boiling point is low, but when you consider the water, boiling point is high. Because of that, these evaporate very quickly, but water takes more time to evaporate. Means the nature of liquid also affect the rate of evaporation. These are some factors which affect the rate of evaporation. Okay, here it completes your first chapter. Okay, I hope you all understand something in this chapter. But if you not understand anything, if you have any doubts in any concept, just ask me. Okay, because due to some condition, I am also not able to clarify, or I am also not able to explain in briefly, and sorry for that. Just read the whatever the notes I send to you and write in your fair, and just refer the videos, and if you have any doubts, then you are free to ask. Okay, yes, then here it completes our first chapter, matter in our surrounding. Okay, thank you so much.